Here at Cohasset Middle High School, we are devoted to providing a safe environment for our students and faculty. A list of procedures has been developed in the case of an emergency, particularly a situation with a violent intruder in the building. This video has been created to inform and educate viewers of what to do in case of such an event. In the case of an emergency, there are three procedures that may be followed. These procedures are labeled shelter-in-place procedure, lockdown procedure, and evacuation procedure.
All right, today we're going to be learning about water. We're going to continue studying what we looked at yesterday.
The first procedure we'll discuss today is the shelter-in-place procedure. Shelter-in-place is used when it has been determined that it is safer inside the building than outside the building. These situations could constitute weather emergencies, medical emergencies, violence or criminal activities outside of the building. In the event that the school needs to shelter in place, the principal or other administrator will announce the order over the public address system. All exterior doors and windows must be locked. Gym classes or other outside activities should report to the gymnasium by the closest point of entry.
Okay, so I want to draw that on the board here, so write this down in your notes. Water is what formula? H2O, good. So H is bonded to O, and that O is bonded to another H. That's H2O, so make sure you draw that and write that down, okay?
Students and faculty, it is necessary at this time to begin a shelter-in-place procedure. All students are to remain in class. Faculty, please lock your doors and windows and continue teaching. An announcement will be made when the situation is clear and we can resume the normal day.
All right, everyone, we're just taking a precaution. This is not an emergency. Stay seated. We're going to continue learning. We just shut the door. All right, so let's continue. Water is H2O. H bonded to O.
Let's rewatch the scene and break down the events. Once the announcement is made, the teacher should do the following. Lock the doors and windows.
All right, everyone, there's not an emergency, but we're taking precautions.
Tell the students to stay calm and assure them that it is not an emergency.
So remain seated, and we're going to continue learning here.
Continue teaching, and lastly, ignore the bells and fire alarm. The second procedure we will discuss is the lockdown procedure. Some situations will require containment of students and staff in a semi-secure space. Students and staff need to barricade the room and be prepared to counterattack or evacuate if necessary. In the event that the school needs to lock down the building, lockdowns will be announced by the principal over the public address system and will designate another staff member to call 911 and report the situation.
Seamus, you remember doing the second lock last year?
Times velocity.
Faculty and students, it is necessary at this time to begin a school-wide lockdown. All students are to remain in class. Students in the hall report immediately to the nearest classroom. Teachers, lock your classroom doors. No one is to leave the classroom until an administrator makes an all-clear announcement. Ignore any fire alarms. If we need to evacuate the building, an announcement will be made. Again, we are in a lockdown.
All right, guys, they're saying that there's a threat in the building. Guys, let's barricade the door. Get the desks over here. Step right up. All right, now get over there by the desk. Get down below so that you're out of sight.
Let's rewatch the scene and break down the events. First, the teacher should lock the door. Next, he barricaded the door with desks for extra protection against unwanted entry. Lastly, the teacher moved students to the safest area of the classroom, away from the windows and doors. He may also prepare to defend himself in case the intruder was able to gain access to the classroom. The teacher and students should remain in the classroom until an announcement is made. If a lockdown procedure is called during a class change, the students are advised to move quickly into the nearest classroom.
Faculty and students, it is necessary at this time to begin a school-wide lockdown. All students are to remain in class. Students in the hall report immediately to the nearest classroom.
Depending on the level of danger faced by the school, there may be a need for students and faculty to evacuate the building. In the event that a full evacuation is required, students, faculty, and staff will be relocated to an alternative location. When instructed to do so, all students, faculty, and staff should evacuate the building and proceed to one of the three designated areas: Woodland Drive, Buttonwood Lane, or 100 Pond Lane. During an emergency evacuation, we will follow the fire evacuation procedures as closely as possible, with the added stop of proceeding to one of the rally points.
Faculty and students, it is necessary at this time to begin a school-wide evacuation. Please carefully and quietly exit the building in the same direction that you would for a fire drill. Faculty members, please lead your students to the predetermined rally points according to your emergency flip charts.
All right, guys, let's unbarricade the door.
In the event of a school evacuation, teachers should follow these steps. 1. Have current hard copies of your class rosters readily available. 2. Lead the class quickly and quietly along the post-evacuation route used in the event of a fire or similar emergency.
Last person out, close the door.
3. Have one student exit last and to close the door upon exiting. Once outside, proceed down the driveway and onto the sidewalks of Pond Street if out front, or onto Alumni Field if out back. 5. Proceed to Woodland Drive, Buttonwood Lane, or 100 Pond Lane, whichever is more convenient. 6. Do not dismiss students to parents without the express consent of an administrator. This ensures that the students are accounted for and that they are released to an authorized adult. In the event that the evacuation occurs during lunch, students will be escorted out the back doors of the cafeteria, onto the practice field, and from there proceed to one of the three designated rally points. A master list of students will be available in the teacher's cafeteria, and an administrator should take attendance. Seniors will exit through the lobby onto the field, proceed to one of the three designated rally points. If an administrator is unavailable at the location, attendance should be taken by a faculty member. Once again, at Cohasset Middle High School, we are devoted to providing a safe environment. We hope that this video serves as a guide for students and faculty in case of an emergency. If you have any questions or concerns regarding the information presented in this video, feel free to contact an administrator or another faculty member.